Peking, China. The summer of the year 1900. The rains are late. The crops have failed. 100 million Chinese are hungry, and a violent wind of discontent disturbs the land. Within the foreign compound, 1,000 foreigners live and work, citizens of 12 far-off nations.
Noise.
Different nations saying the same thing at the same time. We want China.
Separated from the foreign compound by only a wall and a gate is the Forbidden City. Here, in untouchable isolation, lives the Dowager Empress, last of the Manchus. Protected by an army of eunuchs, she holds court and consults with her ministers, mandarins, and generals.
You will halt the execution.
But I have orders from Prince Tuan.
And now you have an order from me.
The nightingale will recover. The arts of the court physician will prevail.
Only yesterday I listened to its song.
Your Highness, the execution has been stopped.
Who?
Yung Lo.
Your Majesty. I come to ask your displeasure, Divine One. Take my life instead of the Colonel's.
We cannot spare you.
It was I who gave the order to the troops to fire on the boxes. They were burning Christian missions, killing foreigners.
We have sad news. The Nightingale. It was your gift. Do you remember, Yung Lo?
I have not forgotten. I live only to serve your Majesty.
And how does the General's attack on the Boxer Patriots serve Her Highness?
If the Boxers remain unchecked, a dozen foreign armies will descend on China.
We are tens of millions. Let them come.
Does the Empress believe that where the Imperial Army has failed, the swords of the rabble will succeed?
Our gods are with the Boxers.
The voice of the Nightingale is still. I hear only the sound of crows.
Your Majesty, a violent wind does not outlast the morning. The Boxers have arisen like the wind and the rain. And like the wind and the rain, they will disappear.
May the Boxers be guided by the will of the gods.
About the Colonel, Your Majesty, let his end be a sign to the people and a warning to the foreigners.
The Colonel's death is of no consequence. But his life has set my prince against my general, and this disturbs the tranquility of the morning. Let him die for this offense. You are concerned, Yung Lo? If the Boxers fail, I will give the foreigners Prince Tuan's head.
In Peking, the capital city of China. This is an ancient and highly cultured civilization. So don't get the idea you're any better than these people just because they can't speak English. A few words of Chinese will go a long way. Repeat after me. The word for yes is shit.
Shit!
The word for no is poo shit.
Poo shit!
Remember, it's just the same here as anywhere else in the world. Everything has a price. So pay your money and don't expect any free samples.
Yes, sir!
Break that up, Major?
You're gonna stay right here.
Murphy!
Yes, sir.
Please tell the boxer chief I'd like to do business with him.
I want to buy that old man.
But he's British. You're American.
$20.
You gonna lose some money? Why should I sell it so cheap?
Chingju! Tell him I'll only do business if the old man's alive. Nothing if he's dead.
跟他要双倍的钱，跟他要嘛。
$40.
All right.
He's dead.
But he say you must pay anyway because you've spoiled the ceremony.
Nothing doing.
$20.
Tell your friend I'm still willing to do business. I'll buy the dead boxer.
$40.
$20. Did you fire that shot?
Yes, sir.
Nice shooting, Sergeant.
Thank you, Major.
That'll cost you $20. Out of your pay.
Fall in!
Hooray, fling!
Baroness, I'm still waiting.
As you know, Your Excellency, I have already sent her a note.
You're the owner of this hotel, Bergman. Tell her yourself.
Voici votre clé, Monsieur le Comte. Excellency, please. Excuse the Signor.
Bergman, in my capacity as a Russian minister to Peking, I order you to get her down here.
As you wish, Your Excellency, but you must remember, she is still a guest. I cannot order her down. Excuse me, Your Excellency, but I think you could do with a cold drink, and so could I.
Champagne, Your Excellency?
How do you meet, Annie?
Oh, you're so beautiful.
Natasha.
How about come on, you quite?
Baroness Ivanov.
Yes, Sergei.
It's not enough that you keep me waiting. Now you choose to ignore me.
You're a little nervous, Sergei. I suggest something cool to drink. For all of us.
不要紧，我们走好了，再见。
Natasha, I try not to talk about the necklace.
But you are talking about it.
I'm talking to you as the Russian Imperial Minister to Peking.
Please, Sergei, just speak to me as my brother-in-law.
Natasha, I've told Mr. Bergman that your visa has been revoked. Consequently, you have no right to remain in this hotel, Peking, or for that matter, anywhere in China. You're legally non-existent.
You frighten me, Sergei.
Where will you go? To your Chinese friends?
You must hate me, Sergei.
You're wrong, Natasha. I do not hate you.
Please leave.
You're a fool. My conscience is clear. But you have lost everything. You will end up naked. In the streets.
Not entirely naked. I'll still have the necklace.
Today. She must be out of here today.
Yes, Your Excellency, I'll take care of it.
Good afternoon, sir.
I hope I get one of the rooms with a bath this time.
I'm sorry, sir. Did you have a reservation?
Well, hello there, Lewis.
Hi.
Hi.
You are late.
When did you get in, Colonel?
This morning.
What kept you so long?
We had a walk the last 10 miles.
The railroad isn't running anymore.
Gentlemen, the railroad isn't anymore.
Major Lewis.
Bergman, haven't you got a room for me?
Our rooms are taken. However, if you wait a short while...
Fine. Thanks, Chang. Here you are.
Thanks, Major. Anytime you need me.
That's half my life in here, Bergman. Take good care of it for me.
And some more of your life here, Major?
Oh, yeah. Let me use your wastebasket.
Well, that's 6 months.
Open a letter, you have to read it. Read it, you may have to answer it.
Luis.
Ah, Carlo.
Carissimo.
Capitano.
You're late.
What kept you so long?
I lost 2 men. Had to stop to bury them.
Come on, Andy. Let's get something to drink.
Right.
Why don't you try to get a room here, too, Andy?
Sure. I want to look up the kid. Maybe find a place closer to her.
Oh, yeah. Your little girl. How old is she now, anyway?
11. Well, I guess she's 12 already. It's rough on her. No mother and practically no father. What else can I do? Now she's with a French mission and a bunch of Chinese orphans.
You're better than most fathers. At least you try to see her when you can.
Yeah, but leaving her at a mission. It's not my idea of how to raise a kid. What do I do? Take her back to Illinois with me? How would a half-Chinese kid make out in Illinois?
I'd treat her like a freak back home. No, she's better off here among her own kind.
You really think so, Matt?
Sure.
May I have your key, Baroness? Must have a room for the American officer.
Besides, you have to live your own life, too. Excuse me, I just had an invitation.
Please do sit down, Major. Bring your friend. We can all drink together.
He'd only tell us his troubles.
What should I tell you, Major?
Well, that you're happy I'm with you.
Are you always this direct?
I'm a Marine, ma'am. I don't have much time.
How much time are you allowing for me?
Now.
Oh? Have you found this approach very successful?
Not really, no, but it's the only one I know.
Keep drinking, Major. The tight uniform will hold you together.
Clever women make me nervous.
Oh, no, please. Please don't go.
What can I offer you? My life?
My room. They just gave it to you. Is that too much to ask?
No, my life isn't worth much, but hotel rooms in Peking are at a premium right now.
Do you always offer your life to strangers?
To a soldier, strangers make the best friends.
But I'm not in uniform, Major.
I like things fine just the way they are.
Major Lewis. Major Lewis, sir, a British orderly to see you.
British Minister's compliments, sir. He wishes to see you. He told me to tell you, sir, that your minister, Mr. Maxwell, is in hospital. But he's been authorized from Washington to act for him.
Oh, fine. Tell him I'll be right along as soon as I get cleaned up.
Yes, sir.
Here's your key, Major.
Thanks.
What shall I do with your belongings, Baroness?
Put them back, Bergman.
But there's only one room, Major.
Let the Baroness figure it out. She's a clever woman.
Don't laugh yet, Major. It's a very small room.
Well, I've been in tight places before.
So have I, Major.
Daddy.
Daddy. Hello, Britain. Good to see you again.
Good day, sir. Now wake up, sentry! Now, take a tip from an old soldier. Whenever you see a major of the American Marines, you will present arms. And don't forget it!
If this be I, as I suppose it be, I have a little dog at home, and he'll know me. Come in.
I'm sorry, Arthur. Are you busy?
Of course I am. I always am.
Busier than usual, or just busy?
Both. Well, what's the pressing female problem?
Just this. Am I to pack or am I not to pack? Are we going to England? Do we take our leave this year or not?
I don't know.
You don't know?
So why don't you just pack, and then if we don't go, all you have to do is to unpack?
If the men had to do the packing and the unpacking, the world would be a very different place.
If I had my way...
What?
You and I would have long since packed and been miles away from here.
You and I. That's a comforting thought. Thank you, darling. Is it all going to go up in flames, Arthur?
Not if I can help it.
What do you mean?
Let me try and put it in a nutshell. If I encourage the policy that the great power should be tough with China, that will bring about a situation where China will become just another battlefield for the great powers to fight over. So I think it's wiser if we accept this temporary humiliation at the hands of the Boxers and hope that by damping down the fire, the kettle won't boil over.
And then?
And then I shall probably receive the displeasure of Her Majesty's government, and you and I will be retired upon a most inadequate pension.
Do you remember what Napoleon said about China?
I never forget it. Let China sleep, for when she wakes, the world will tremble.
He did say an awful lot, didn't he?
Come in.
Major Lewis, Sir Arthur.
Oh, ask him to wait one moment. Darling, forgive me. I had to put on my official face for a little while. You haven't forgotten our soiree tonight.
Two dozen bottles of champagne already on the ice. Anything else the sir will require?
The first waltz, if you can spare it.
I'll think about it.
Philip!
Major Lewis, Sir Arthur.
Major, do you want to stand up or sit down or walk around the room? Personally, I'm going to walk around the room, but you please yourself. I have a most unpleasant task to fulfill. So first of all, I'd like to congratulate you on the initiative you showed this morning with Father Beamish.
We were a little late.
It's most unfortunate that a Chinese was killed.
A boxer?
A Chinese citizen, Major. You're not in the Wild West now, you know. You don't go around shooting Chinese like you do Red Indians.
No, sir.
And secondly, I want to warn you that any repetition of your irresponsible behavior could very easily involve the last remaining members of the human race in a conflagration of considerable proportions.
I understand.
And lastly, since your own minister is suffering from what might turn out to be a diplomatic illness, it's I who have to tell you that your presence in this city is no longer required.
No longer required by whom?
Major, I am just relaying a message from your own legation. Personally, I'd be delighted if you stayed.
Yes, sir.
Look, I suppose you know all hell's going to break loose here.
If all hell is going to break loose, it will not be because we have provoked it. So we'll all just walk softly and hope for the best.
Even if we walk on our knees, we can't stop this. I have just marched 70 miles from Tenzin. There are boxers everywhere. They're killing every white man, especially missionaries, and every Chinese Christian they can find. And the Imperial Army isn't lifting a finger to stop them.
The Boxer bandits have been with us for years, Major. It could be that you're unnecessarily alarmed.
Well, the next time I see some bandits murdering an English priest, I'll try not to be alarmed.
I've been a soldier myself, Major. I understand exactly how you feel. But as a diplomat, I have to try and look at the larger picture.
I wouldn't know about the large picture. I just do a job patrolling the rice paddies out in the back country. But I know this much. If the Boxers get as far as Peking, you're going to wish there were more soldiers in these compounds and less women and children.
Well, now we both had our say.
I'll go quietly.
Oh, by the way, it's our Queen's birthday today, and we're entertaining tonight. We'd be delighted if you'd come.
Thank you.
I won't leave Ming behind. I'll pack him in my case.
Don't be silly, Tommy. He'd suffocate.
What's that?
He wouldn't be able to breathe.
It's only for 5 weeks.
Come on. Let's go and see Father. May we speak to you, Father?
It's very important.
There are no secret negotiations in progress at the moment. What's the problem?
Mother says we can't take Ming back to England with us.
I won't leave my dog.
He's my dog.
Who feeds him?
Who taught him to sit up? He's mine.
I tell you what, we'll cut him exactly in two, and you'll each get half.
Oh, Father, don't play King Solomon.
I tried.
Thank you.
Welcome, Prince Tuan, to Her Britannic Majesty's legation.
I am deeply honored.
His Imperial Highness, Prince Tuan.
I bring greetings from our Empress.
You are most welcome, Your Imperial Highness.
Greetings and felicitations to your great queen. Of China and the Lion of Great Britain live in peace forever.
Our Queen is most touched by the thoughtfulness and the generosity of your illustrious Empress.
Your Imperial Highness, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the first dance will be the military two-step.
They should be around my neck.
Of course, Sophie. You look positively naked without them.
To the end of the line, Baroness?
Oh, no. No, not yet. I've been waiting for this for a long time. Now I'm enjoying it.
With your glitter.
Would you recognize me without them, Sonia?
Major Lewis, I understand you're going to Tientsin tomorrow.
That's right, Your Excellency.
There is a Russian woman here who has no transit visa and wishes to leave Peking.
Anyone we know, Sergei?
Naturally, it would be in her interest to get to know you. It might be the only chance to reach Tientsin.
It might be.
If you disregard this, I assure you the Russian government will remember this conversation.
Good evening, Major.
Lady Robertson.
I've been wanting to thank you personally, Major Lewis, for trying to help poor Father Beamish.
You know the Baroness?
Yes, of course.
It's been a long time, hasn't it?
I know that my husband has already thanked you.
Yes, I have already expressed my gratitude. Sir, may I present the Baroness Ivanov and Major Lewis?
Your Highness?
You must be the American who had the unfortunate encounter with the boxers this morning.
I'm afraid it was the British missionary who had the hard time, sir.
The Chinese government is most distressed, but you must not conclude that all boxers are bandits. Most of them are harmless vagabonds, entertainers in the marketplaces, much like the gypsies in your country. In fact, Sir Arthur, I have taken the liberty of bringing such a troop to entertain your guests tonight.
Boxers? Here?
With your permission.
Of course, Your Imperial Highness.
He wants you to take the sword and try to strike him.
Try it, Major. Seems to be part of the performance.
If I kill a boxer, Sir Arthur, does that create a diplomatic incident?
There is no danger.
I think you made your point, Major.
Not quite.
Bravo!
I guess he wasn't a true believer.
It seems, Sir Arthur, it is your troops who are invulnerable.
You must forgive us, Your Highness, but the Major does not seem to understand that here we must play the game according to Chinese rules.
I apologize, Sir Arthur, but I don't think His Highness came here tonight to play games. Good night.
Unfortunately, Sir Arthur, I must return to my duties at the palace. Do not bother to escort me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next dance will be a waltz.
May I have a word with you, Sir Arthur?
not only an insult to the British, but an affront and a challenge to all powers.
A full report of this outrage will go to the Kaiser himself.
I just want to assure the gentleman that Her Majesty's government is not unduly alarmed by this Boxer invasion of the British embassy.
I shall personally lodge a complaint with the Chinese Foreign Office in the morning.
And what are you going to do, Sir Arthur?
I don't know what all of you are going to do, but I intend to have a glass of champagne.
I admire Sir Arthur. He always gives me the feeling that God must be an Englishman.
We go and we go, but we don't get anywhere. Why don't we just go back to the hotel?
Are you tired, Major?
Tired? No. Ready to turn in, maybe.
Have you ever been inside this temple, Major?
I think we could get a better drink at the hotel. Very interesting. Can we go now?
But we haven't had our dance yet, Major. Shall we?
What happens to you in Tientsin?
I'll be entirely in your hands, Major.
You're in my hands now, but you seem to keep slipping through my fingers.
You know, I think I'll get you to take me to San Francisco with you.
Oh? Why to San Francisco?
Well, isn't that the place where they found all the gold? Just a minute.
What's a trinket like that worth, anyway?
A lot of money.
Like we won't be leaving today after all. They just killed the German minister.
But, Matt, we must leave. I have to leave.
You have to wait.
Your sword, Sir Arthur.
You are well, Sir Arthur?
I am well, if you are well, Your Majesty.
We are pleased to receive you.
Your Majesty does me great honor.
We have been informed of the unhappy death of the German minister. The Boxer bandits will be dealt with.
But the anger of the Chinese people cannot be quieted so easily.
The Germans have seized Kiao Chau. The Russians have seized Port Arthur. The French have obtained concessions in Yunnan, Guangxi, and Kuangtung. In all, 13 of the 18 provinces of China are under foreign control. Foreign warships occupy our harbors. Foreign armies occupy our forts. Foreign merchants administer our banks. Foreign gods disturb the spirits of our ancestors. Is it surprising that our people are aroused?
Your Majesty will permit me to observe that the violence of the Boxers will not redress the grievances of China.
China is a prostrate cow. The powers are no longer content to milk her. Now they are butchering her for her meat.
If China is a cow, Your Majesty, she is indeed a marvelous animal that not only gives meat as well as milk, but at the same time grows stronger. She's learning new arts of peace from the West. But China's greatest virtue is her patience. And if she will exercise that now, she will achieve everything.
And if not?
If not, if the counsels of violence and impatience prevail, then the blood of millions will be shed and the agony will be prolonged.
Will you please go to the window, Sir Arthur? There is something I have arranged for you to see. I hope you will inform your government that Chinese justice is swift and thorough. Those men are the ones who murdered Baron von Meck this morning.
Where lies the guilt? With the one who wields the sword or the one who gives the command?
You know who gave the command?
With your Majesty's permission, I would like to present an eyewitness.
By all means, Sir Arthur.
Major Lewis, Your Majesty.
Evidently, Major, you are in possession of secret information about the Boxer leadership.
It's not much of a secret, Your Highness.
Please go on, Major Lewis.
I saw the man who commanded the Boxers this morning. The one who ordered the attack on the German minister.
You would know him?
It was Prince Tuan.
You believe this story, Sir Arthur?
I do, Your Majesty.
And you have come here to ask us to take action against Prince Tuan?
I have come here with the truth. The truth that is already known to the German government and to all the other powers.
We reject your truth, Sir Arthur, and your protest. We are pleased to inform you that Prince Tuan is our closest and most trusted advisor. Only this morning we appointed him to head the Foreign Office.
For our part, Your Majesty, Great Britain wants nothing more than continued friendly relations with China.
Because of the protracted drought, because of hunger and unrest among my people, because of the merciless demands of the foreign powers, the situation in Peking cannot be expected to become tranquil. Therefore, we earnestly advise you, Sir Arthur, that all foreign residents, including diplomatic personnel, should leave Peking within 24 hours.
Is Your Majesty informing me that she is severing diplomatic relations with all the powers?
Not at all. Her Majesty was clear enough. Her Highness is offering informal advice for your safety and protection.
I'm in favor of that,
Major Lewis.
If she can't control the Boxers, we'd better get out before we're wiped out.
Prince Tuan, you will be responsible to see that these gentlemen are escorted safely to their legations.
We might do better on our own.
walk?
Yes, very slowly.
Need some help, sir.
Yes, thank you, John.
Well, count the votes.
You're waiting for the American minister. Ah, Mr. Maxwell. Sorry to drag you out of your sick bed, but we need your vote on whether to stay or leave Peking.
The United States has no territorial concession in China. Never asked for one, don't want one. I'm afraid I have to abstain, Sir Arthur.
I understand, Mr. Maxwell. I just wanted you to witness the proceedings. Well, congratulations, gentlemen. You have all voted to go. There are 9 votes to leave Peking. Great Britain has voted to stay. We'll stay alone if necessary.
But that is not acceptable. We will all look ridiculous if we flee from Peking and the British remain.
Perhaps there is a reason why the British would like to remain here alone, the only foreign power in Peking.
My French colleague may be right. Perhaps Sir Arthur has some private information.
I have made my position absolutely clear. Admiral Sidney is already on his way to Peking with a force of several thousand men. He will be here at the most in 9 days. In the meantime, I, for one, have no intention of displaying fear of the Boxers, nor of handing a victory to Prince Tuan.
If the British stay, the Germans stay.
Surely, Sir Arthur, you realize that we here must make a decision in the interests of our thousands of civilians. Do you wish to be the one man who's standing in the way of their safe evacuation?
I have, of course, appreciated the risk, Senor Goodsman. But I believe if we all stand united, that the Chinese won't dare mount a serious attack upon the representatives of the 11 great powers. And if we do all stand firm, we may preserve peace in China and indeed in the whole world.
Perhaps you are right, Sir Arthur. If the other powers decide to stay, Austria will have no choice.
Congratulations, Sir Arthur. It seems the British have won another bloodless victory.
I take it you have now unanimously decided to stay.
I shall report in my diary that the first vote was 9-1, and that, in a friendly spirit, it was then decided to make the decision unanimous.
Well, if that's decided, gentlemen, I suggest we call in the military.
This way, please, gentlemen.
So, Colonel Sheba will give the majority report.
Considering the military aspects of the situation, we have agreed that with fewer than 400 men to defend a perimeter of over 2 miles, the position is untenable. We recommend immediate evacuation.
The ministers have decided that for political reasons we must remain. So you will have to defend the area to the best of your abilities until Admiral Sidney's relieving force arrives.
Sir, what if the relief column doesn't make it? They have to cover over 70 miles through hostile territory.
We will consider that situation if and when it arises.
There are 5 main defense sectors. The wall, defended by the Germans and the Americans. The West End, defended by the Russians. The British Legation, the Fu, held by the Americans and the Japanese.
And the East End of Legation Street, which is held by the Italians and the French.
Boxers?
Yeah.
Where are they? Where the hell are they?
They're all around us. Don't be nervous. It's their purpose. Once the shooting starts, you will see them. Every one of them will be outside that wall.
Who's nervous?
No. No, you can't have them.
Sarah, we agreed. We need the books for the barricades. I thought you'd be the first to understand.
Not the complete set of the Napoleonic Wars. Mother just sent them to you for your birthday.
I have a confession to make. French history bores me.
Ici, ici.
English history. Bah.
Fermez les
closed.
It's Baroness Ivanov. I thought all doors in Peking had been closed to me. That I'd lost face in the Chinese streets.
Our Empress has those same fears, Baroness.
Boxers.
It is hoped her wisdom will prevail.
I have your message, old one.
Your friend thinks you should leave Peking.
What friend, old one?
General Yung Lo. It was not possible before. Your husband's brother would have accused us of meddling in Russian affairs.
And now?
Now? It makes no difference. There will be a Boxer attack. If you should disappear in the first confusion, who will be left to point a finger? At 5 o'clock this afternoon, the fighting will have begun. You will meet a man at the corner of the French legation. He will be wearing a green peasant jacket. You will be there?
Murphy, go up in the ramp and find out how they're coming.
Yes, sir.
Got. Sergeant, make those men get their backs into it.
Right. Hey, what the...
Hold it.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm getting out of Peking.
Don't you know there are some angry boxers out there?
They're not angry with me.
We average 200 rounds apiece, Major.
That's 20 rounds each man each day.
20 rounds, that's for warming up.
You tell them they better start out warm.
Yes, sir, I'll tell them. Start out warm.
Will you get out of there before I get mad?
Mad Americans inside, mad boxers outside, mad Russians all over the place. I'll take my chances outside.
Major, I split the men in 2 platoons. 4 hours on, 4 hours off.
The sergeant will take the first watch, you take the second.
Right.
I wanted to go to that thing with you. But you want to stay here and play soldier.
I wear a uniform. That's the job they pay me to do.
Well, then go and do it. And get out of my way. Have a nice war, soldier. A real nice war.
Where will these go, Major?
Well, where do you think they go? Get up on that wall!
Thank you.
Corporal!
Althofer!
We did it! We beat him!
What do we do if we come back?
We used more than half our ammunition today.
How good are you with a slingshot?
Friend of yours, Baroness?
Soldier, can you open this door?
You can't go through there, man. There are Chinese on the other side. That was a bit of bad luck. It'll be all right.
I'll get some help.
Well, what do you make of it, Major?
Well, Father, this is quite a weapon. What would you call it?
Well, you might say she's a cross between an alligator and an ostrich, but we call her Betsy, after the Dowager Empress of China. We found this old German gun barrel and some Russian shells of approximately the same caliber. The gun carriage is Italian, and the wheels are French. And that boy over there is fool enough to say you'll fire it.
I wonder if it'll be safer in front or in back.
The point is, where's Betsy going to be fired?
Well, we need a new British location. We're exposed on both sides.
Major Lewis, sir. Captain Marshall wants you.
What's up?
Chinese are on top of the wall, sir. That's what's up, sir.
Well, now we know where Betsy goes.
Here, over here, you.
Just too many of them. They keep right on coming.
Major Lewis!
How many did we lose?
Turner got it. So did Spencer. 5 wounded. I don't know about the Germans. I guess they got it even worse.
Huh? I don't know why they don't rush us right now. We wouldn't stand a chance here.
Maybe they think we've got millions of men and tons of ammunition.
Well, come morning, they'll think different. They'll roll down those ramps like Niagara Falls. We got to get him off this wall.
We can't.
Andy, if they stay there, they can shoot down into the whole legation area like fish in a barrel.
Either we get them off the wall or we might just as well open the gates and let them in.
You get the French priest and meet us in the legation.
Right.
I don't think they're going to start anything up here till morning, Sergeant. And you better hope they don't. No sign of activity, hmm?
No, sir. I think they're all asleep.
Aye, well, we'd better not be, Sergeant. You'd better wake them all up.
Yes, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Here they go!
Why didn't we get out when we could?
I don't know, Harry. I really don't know.
Captain Handy told me that you retook the wall. I suppose you heard. He died, too.
Maybe the minister can tell us why the captain's dead. And Captain Marshall. From what I hear, he has all the answers.
That's all, Sergeant. Get on back. He's a good soldier when he knows what he's fighting for.
It's easier when it's something you can see. A wall, a hill, a river. But how can you explain to them when it's for a principle?
You can't. Not here in China. It's too far from home.
I know.
Somebody! I won't stay. Don't want him to take my leg. I won't let them take my leg. Just tell them to let
Hold
take
on,
my
soldier.
Leg.
Hold on.
Don't want to live half a man.
He's only fainted. You can go now.
Can you save his leg? May I stay here with him?
Your dress is
breeding ground for germs. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of it and put on a uniform.
Thank you, Doctor.
Who's going to tell her? The captain's little girl, remember?
It's pretty late now. I guess we can tell her in the morning.
She might hear about it from somebody else. That wouldn't be right.
No, I guess not. Let's get a drink first.
Afterwards.
You coming?
I gotta get back on the wall.
Wait a minute. All right. Where'll I find her?
With the rest of the orphans in the Foo.
What do I tell her?
Like she was your own, I guess. Tell her like you'd like someone to tell your own kid.
Don't you know which one she is?
No. There are so many new children who just came in today. Haven't you ever met her?
Yeah, once, but I can't remember what she looks like. I didn't pay much attention.
Ah, Major.
We're looking for the Marshall girl.
Of course, yes. Teresa.
I heard. I guess she must be sleeping. Maybe you could tell her in the morning.
I think it's important that you tell her, Major. After all, she knows that you were her father's friend. I'll wake her.
Ah, here she is. Here's someone to see you. A friend of your father's.
Teresa. Do you remember me?
Yes, Major.
I have something to tell you.
Now, why don't the two of you stay here and talk?
I guess you know there's been some fighting. Well, as I said, there's something I have to tell you.
Is it about my father?
Yes.
Is he dead?
Did you know? You knew he was a soldier. It could have happened any time. You'll be taken care of. You won't have to worry about anything. She'll be all right now, huh?
Won't I be going home then?
Home?
to America. He said he'd take me home.
He did. When?
Every time. Just today again.
I don't think you'd like it there. Everything's very strange. Things are all different there. The people and the food and the houses and the schools.
Anyway, if you want, we can talk about it some more. In a few days when things quiet down. I promise. She understood.
A mother dies, a child feels deserted. When a father goes away, even for the best reasons, the child feels abandoned. Teresa's had more than her fair share. She understands too well.
I don't know what else I could have told her.
There's only one language a child understands. Love.
Not mine.
Someone somewhere said that every man is the father of every child. But I suppose it's only true if you really feel it.
Thank you.
The British Admiral and his forces are trapped between Langfang and Amping. The Boxers do not climb a tree to look for a fish.
They have done their work well. The railway is destroyed before him and to his rear. He can neither proceed nor retreat.
You see, General, the Boxers are not as useless as you believed.
Your Majesty, it does not require courage or skill to rip up a few rails. The Boxers flee from the foreign devils. If Admiral Sidney be denied the use of the railway, he will now march on Peking. I expect him here within the week.
It is true, Your Majesty. The Boxers are not equipped to stop such a well-armed force. Only General Yang Lo's Imperial troops can do that.
The Imperial troops have no part in this foolish uprising.
The Imperial troops will do as Her Majesty commands.
Who is there who can make muddy water clear?
Your Majesty, first we were told that the Boxers would destroy all the foreigners in Peking within 2 days. Next, we were assured that no foreign army would ever even approach the city. If we commit the Imperial armies against Admiral Sidney, we shall be declaring war on all the powers. Our armies, for all their courage and devotion, could not possibly win such a war.
The Boxers have created an opportunity for a great Chinese victory. If our troops destroy the foreign forces, it will prove to all the world that China is no longer helpless. It will be the beginning of freedom.
Each of you speaks with the voice of a patriot. Prince Tuan counsels a reckless adventure. General Yang Lo counsels prudence and patience. Prudence and patience for what? China's condition can be no worse than it is. Even if we should start a war and lose it, what more can the powers take from us? General Yang Lo, you will personally command our troops and turn back the foreign armies.
Stop it, Tommy. Go away, Tommy. You'll wake the baby.
You can't talk. You're dead. Bang, bang, bang.
You're not to play at that end.
Bang, bang.
Oh, Tommy.
Bang, bang.
If he dies, he wouldn't ever have been home. Funny how he used to talk about home. As if he remembered how it was. How he fed the ducks at St. James's Park. Hard. He must have picked it up from me. You never talked to him about home, did you, Arthur?
Yes, I did sometimes.
No, I have the strangest feeling. I can't get it out of my mind.
What is it?
Do you think that if a child dies in a foreign place without ever having been home, that his soul doesn't rest? I think it goes into limbo. An enormous enormous empty Chinese limbo. And it wanders there lost and crying.
He's not going to die.
So why doesn't he waken up?
The doctor says he's in a coma. He may not come around for several days.
The truth is he may not come round at all. He may never come out of it. Why? Why? How did he sin? Against whom? What's he doing in this foreign place? Whose ambition is he serving? Must a child die to serve the ends of ambitious and powerful men? Who will gain from his death? Who will be the happier for it? How many children must die? How many people must suffer before there's an end to all this? Don't you see that even the life of one child is too great a price to pay? It's too great a price to pay.
Sarah, try to understand.
Understand what? Tell me, tell me.
The pain is not yours alone.
Have you ever been to England, Baroness?
Yes.
Manchester?
No. It must be very beautiful.
I don't think you call it beautiful. But you know how it is when you come from a far place.
Go to sleep now. You might dream of Manchester. It would be like a visit home.
Slowly. That's right.
Count Litnov is a second cousin to the Tsarina. You cannot treat him like a common soldier.
The bullet that hit him was not afraid of wounding a count. And the germs in his wound do not care if he's the first cousin of the Tsarina. He will be treated the same as any man in this hospital. Good day, Baron.
I understand you're here early and late. A true angel of mercy. The wounded man won't be nursed by anyone else.
You have always known that I have a way with men, Sergei.
Even the German doctor has fallen under your spell.
He can't do without me.
And the major? The American major?
What do you want?
I would like to be present when he finds out what you are.
You'll be present. You'll be the one who tells him. You're just waiting for the right moment.
Where is it?
Right there.
Open it up. Ouvrez la porte.
There you are, Sir Arthur. I've got a message for you from Admiral Sidney.
It's good to see you, Reverend Michelson.
Oh, dear, dear. Now, where have I put it? Hope I didn't lose it.
Where did you see Admiral Sidney?
One thing at a time, sir. Here it is.
It's in code. I'll have to get it deciphered. Come with me.
With a mixed force of 2,200 officers and men, I proceeded by rail as far as Anping. There I encountered heavy opposition from large forces of Chinese imperial troops. I sustained casualties of over 10% and considerable loss of material. It was impossible to continue toward Peking. I have been forced to order a retreat along the Pei Ho River toward Tientsin. Signed, Harold Sidney.
Doesn't he say something?
No! About the future! What does he say?
We missed you at dinner. I thought you should have something to eat.
Thank you, Sarah.
Do you want some more light?
No, thanks. Why are we here, Sarah? You asked me that once. Why did we stay when we could have gone?
I'm sorry, Arthur. I'd no right to put it that way.
Well, there comes a time when it's good to ask questions. I've been lying here for hours, asking myself many.
What questions?
Question. Who am I? Question. What have I accomplished in 20 years in the Foreign Service? Question. Am I a successful diplomat or a misfit, suitable only for a backwater like Peking? Question. Am I an honest man who tried to avert war in China? Or am I an ambitious one who sought to further his own career? Question. Am I a fool who took an impossible gamble? Or a reasonable man who took a reasonable chance? And what sort of father and husband am I to risk everything that I love? And who am I to plague God with the precious lives of so many people?
I've been with you, Arthur, as long as you've been with the Foreign Service. I know something about those 20 years. And something about you. I know that only an honest man would ask such questions.
Excellency? I was just leaving, Major. The Baroness and I were talking over old times.
Don't go. My brother-in-law can't rest. He has something to tell you.
This is a family matter, Natasha. We needn't discuss it before strangers.
Stop playing games, Sergei. Get it over with now.
They're talking about my dead brother, the Baroness's husband.
I'm really not interested.
What kind of a man do you suppose he was? Something like me, fat, past middle age?
Something like that.
He was the youngest colonel in the Russian army. A brilliant career ahead of him. The Tsar himself had taken personal notice. Do you know why my brother died?
No.
Go on.
I can't call it suddenly.
He killed himself. Because I was unfaithful to him.
Let's forget it.
The man was a general. A Chinese general. Can't you imagine yourself in love with a Chinese girl? That's not the same, is it?
Well, I guess a man gets what he deserves.
What the hell can I offer? A soldier's pay?
Yes.
Well, a soldier's pay buys a soldier's woman.
An urgent message from Her Imperial Highness. And therefore, in view of the unprovoked aggression by the armed forces of Great Britain, Germany, Russia, France, the United States, Japan, Italy, and Austria, under the command of Admiral Harold Sidney, the Imperial Chinese government demands the immediate and unconditional surrender of the armed forces of these nations in Peking, and the surrender of all their weapons. We will await your reply.
I believe, Sir Arthur, I can say without fear of contradiction that you are the architect of our dilemma. What do you propose now?
I think, gentlemen, you should know the military facts. We have had almost 100 casualties, about 25% of our forces. Our ammunition is more than half gone. The food situation is bad. Medical supplies are non-existent. And by any reasonable estimate, it will take 4 or 5 weeks to assemble a sufficient force on the coast to fight through to Peking.
What is your answer to that?
We're all very well aware of our own weakness. I have been giving some thought to the weakness of the Chinese. It's quite clear that Prince Tuan persuaded the Empress to commit the Imperial troops in the hopes of a quick and easy victory. It's also clear that he allowed Reverend Michelson through the lines with Admiral Sidney's letter in the hopes that we would promptly collapse. This ultimatum means that he has promised the Empress our immediate surrender. Now, if instead of collapsing, we show unexpected strength, and not only hold out, but attack, at the very moment when they least expect it, we might destroy Tuan's influence with the Empress and force her to face reality.
Our British colleague is a man of faith. He believes if we blow our trumpets, it may cause the walls of the Imperial City to collapse, like the walls of Jericho. How many trumpets do we have, Major?
I don't know, Baron, but I think maybe Sir Arthur has a good idea about the Empress.
About the Empress, I hope you did not misunderstand. Any attempt on her life would be a disaster.
I wouldn't even know how to go about getting at her.
I do not want her killed.
You don't want?
Her death would mean chaos. We'd have no one with whom we could negotiate. We'd be fighting here in China for 20 years.
Do you have a better idea?
I give you my word, Major. We'll only increase the frenzy of the Chinese and enlarge the war.
All right, you fight the wars. Just let us fight the battles, will you?
Come on, Colonel. What do you think, Colonel?
Yes, I'm thinking. If you're thinking what I think you're thinking, and then I'm afraid I must agree with Sir Arthur.
They're using the big guns now.
That means the Empress has committed the Imperial troops. Get everyone into the compound. Here, Sergeant. Take the baby.
Arthur! Arthur! Tommy's all right. He's all right. He just woke up. He spoke to me. He's going to live. He's going to live.
Live?
Wait for Admiral Sidney.
Sidney's not coming.
Now you think we should attack.
Attack who? The
whole Imperial Army in attack with what? 115 rusty guns?
I just got word that Tuan is preparing an enormous victory celebration for the Empress in the Imperial courtyard for tonight.
I suppose we're all invited.
I still say that we should do something instead of surrendering. Something that would make Tuan lose face.
Well, we could blow up the palace.
You know, the Chinese have a very well-stocked arsenal not too far away from the Imperial City. What would happen if that went up?
I know about that
arsenal. Right in the middle of their little party.
I also know it's a mile and a half through their lines.
I'm not talking about going through their lines. I'm talking about going underneath them. Look at your map. I think we can get to that arsenal by way of the sewer and blow the whole thing up just when Tuan's telling the Empress that the foreign devils are completely defeated.
Right through here.
Of course, how we get back again is another question.
We?
It doesn't take a military genius, Major, to crawl through a sewer.
Come on.
goes off now, we'll be blown sky high. I'm going to have to cut the fuse.
Short. If we light it now, we'll never get clear.
Get these two ends joined together.
I suppose, Prince Tuan, you have come to report the complete destruction of the legations. This will be the 10th time since the end of the last moon.
I have come, Divine One, to ask your Majesty's permission to impeach General Yang Lao as a traitor and a friend to the barbarians. It is true, he turned back the foreign admiral, but he has guns the Boxers need, and he refuses to lend these guns, even though your Majesty commands it.
Be silent. General Yang Lao, despite the empty promises of the Boxers, the foreign devils grow stronger each day. Even the Forbidden City is no longer safe. There is no greater calamity than to underestimate an enemy. You will speak to the foreigners, Yang Lao. You will explain to them there is no greater blessing than peace. No greater calamity than lightly engaging in war.
Throw down the line.
got?
It's a message for each of the ministers.
See these get delivered.
Yes.
General Yang Lu. Seems they want a truce. He really must have spoiled the Empress's party last night.
No, she's just as likely to wake up in the morning and decide it's a fine day to finish us off. What does she say?
We are greatly disturbed by the arrival of Allied troops at the city of Tientsin.
Tientsin?
Unless these troops are withdrawn immediately, the Chinese government will consider it an act of war and will commit the forces of the Imperial Army.
Allied troops in Tientsin?
Apparently, but they must think we're all dead here by now.
That's only 70 miles away.
Yes. If only we could get word to them.
You mean if I could get word to them? Oh, no. Old soldiers never volunteer.
Is waiting for you. This is not a reception hall in the Winter Palace.
Are you coming back?
Sure, if I can.
Natasha!
This...
What did he want?
Do you think people can change, Doctor?
I don't know. That is something I cannot study under a microscope.
You look wonderful. You shaved.
You always notice, Baroness.
Get me some adhesive, please.
Never did get a chance to talk, did we? Look, I have to go someplace, but I'm coming back.
Like my father.
I'm coming back. We'll talk then. All right.
Come on!
There should be another bottle of ether. Where is it?
You say that every day, Doctor.
Because I know there was one.
We used it over a week ago.
And the morphine?
It's all gone, you know it.
Well, tomorrow we'll have to operate on the Italian regard. If he's lucky, he'll faint and feel nothing. Iodine.
Here, Doctor.
This is empty.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Now, don't stand here. Get me another bottle.
But this was the last bottle.
No alcohol, no iodine. Amateur nurses. We are back in the dark ages. ether for anesthetics. No morphine for pain. We are in the land of opium. There are no opiates.
Rogers, you all right?
Fire!
Major, I'm hurt. I'm hurt bad. Oh.
I'll get you back.
Death in the weather, old man. And yet your door is open.
The door, open or closed, cannot protect either of us.
And life. And death, old man. Are they important?
Not to the gods.
There are many men dying in pain. They need drugs.
I do not deal in opiates.
There are others in the city who do.
The Chinese outside the walls are the only ones who can help you now, Baroness.
Even in war times, old man, a valuable gift placed high enough can work miracles. I want the drugs today, and a wagon loaded with fruit for the children.
How'd you do it, Baroness?
Major, I heard you were back.
Scott, come on. Major. Major, wake up. Wake up.
The rails.
What?
The railroad tracks. They're much closer.
How close are they?
Almost up to the wall.
All right. Give me a shirt.
Did they tell you about the Baroness?
No.
She was shot.
What?
I think she'll be all right, though. She's in the hospital. Major, we better hurry.
Yeah.
saw her, Doctor.
You must let me try again, Natasha. Soon it will be too late.
You've done everything you can do.
I must locate the focus of the infection.
You won't find it with a knife, Doctor.
Don't you want to live?
I've lived.
Don't think back. Don't think of anything now, except of living. Give yourself a chance.
A chance for what? Chance to do it all over again. No, thank you, Doctor.
If you die, Natasha, all the light will be gone from this place.
You're the one. Makes all the light in this place.
I hope you forgive me when I say it. In the weeks we have worked together, I have learned to care for you very much.
Oh, I'm glad you said that, Hans. A woman always likes to hear it. Most men haven't the courage to say it.
They're closer than they were when I left.
If they were planning on bringing up a big gun, they wouldn't have to come this close.
Yeah. Go get Father De Bien.
Yes, sir.
Major.
Did you ever see anything like that before?
Certainly I have not.
Stop it with something.
Get me those two bronze urns from the tower there. And all the coal oil you can find. And some black powder. And all the empty champagne bottles you can find, too.
Stop!
that one there. Pile up these sandbags. Go on, higher than that. That's about it. Now, where are those bottles? The powder. Come on, hurry. That's it.
I always have these chaps, everybody at the devil!
Oh, a little prayer and a lot of luck.
A bad luck.
Bad luck indeed. You weren't praying hard enough. Now.
Now get on those hoses, will you? What's wrong up there?
I'll try harder next time.
Be terrible to be a soldier, Major.
Yeah. Sometimes it is.
Get those buckets moving! Over there! Come on now! Quicker! Down the pump! Get working on that pump, you two so all together!
I've been looking for you. The Baroness is dead. Don't you have anything to say? She didn't mean much to you, did she?
Shut up.
Sorry.
Let me alone,
sir.
Let me alone!
I just heard. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Well, we bought ourselves another day anyway.
Still, it wasn't a bad fight, you know.
What time is it?
5:37 a.m., August the 14th, 1900.
How many days did we hold out?
55.
those guns? They're not Chinese.
Running away.
Water can support a ship. And water can upset it. The dynasty is finished. The dynasty is finished.
all playing different tunes again.
Well, for 55 days we played the same tune.
55 days. You held us together. You started something at that. Maybe people will remember someday.
We're ready to march, Major.
Right with you.
You were staying on in China?
I go where they send me. How about you?
Well, I'll be going home to England. Retired to private life, I suppose. A little place in the country with a dog and a few good books. Mm. Every Englishman's dream, really. And you? What's home for you?
I don't know. I may have to make one yet.
Good luck, Matt.
Shoulder! Helm!
Take my hand. Forward! Ho!
These very scars. Well.
so little time.
So little time.
So little time to.